So my parents both immigrated from Turkey in the 1990s. My mom was a stay-at-home mom. Neither of my parents went to college. So my dad, he had a pizzeria at one point. He was a limo driver, and he was also a handyman. When I was 6 years old, my dad passed away from a heart attack. It was difficult. My mom was faced with the decision either to stay in America or we can go back to Turkey where we'd be financially stable. She thought, no, I need to stay here. She has a chance here and I don't care what I have to do. We're gonna keep going. One of the biggest things that my mom did for me was no matter how rough things were, I was always able to get books. So I kept reading and I kept finding the love for the things that I wanted to do. And sooner or later, you know, when you find out that your dad passed away from a heart attack and when you later find out that it could have been preventable, you're like, well, I'm definitely staying with medicine. Before Wesleyan, the label of first generation student had never come up in my life. In my high school, again, no one identified as that. So I didn't think that that was actually a thing. So when I first started applying for colleges, you know, the first generation student label came up and I was like, I am this, you know, this is who I am. And I started to actually think about what it meant to be first gen. Once I, you know, became a part of the Wesleyan community, I got an email that was like, apply for First Things First. And I was like, what is this? And it's basically a pre-orientation program. We come 3 days early for first generation low income students to kind of get used to Wesleyan and get the resources that they need just to become on par with, you know, students who aren't first generation or low income. All of our stories are different, very different stories, but we had this common thread. We're in a school that's incredible, that like will make our dreams come true, basically. It's been a year and a half since I've been to First Things First, since the orientation program, and I still talk to the same people. Yes, I'm first generation and low income, but I'm also a scientist, I'm a musician, I'm Muslim. You know, I'm all of these different labels that come together into, say, first generation and low income.